Welcome to the Virgin TV British Academy Television Awards 2018. Live from the heart of London at the Royal Festival Hall, we are here to celebrate the best programmes and performances of the last 12 months. Our first glamorous guests are arriving. It's going to be a magical night. BAFTAs awarded tonight include leading actor and actress. The titans of Saturday Night TV are battling it out for the Entertainment BAFTA. Who will be taking home the BAFTA for Female in a Comedy? And in the clash of the reality shows, who will triumph? Which of our Male in a Comedy nominees will come out on top? What will be your must-see TV moment of the past year? Take your seats and get ready for the most prestigious award ceremony on TV. This is the British Academy Television Awards, and the stars are shining bright tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your host, Sir Perkins!
Thank you so much, thank you. And thank you for that wonderful entrance. Typical, of course, 10 men blowing their own trumpets before a woman even so much as opens her mouth. The Scots Guards, ladies and gentlemen. I actually found them in Claire Foy's dressing room. She is thrillingly method, that lady. Good evening and welcome to the Virgin TV British Academy Television Awards 2018, the original home of the hostile environment. I'm Sue Perkins. You might know me from leaving some of the most successful shows on television. What an honour it is to present this most stellar of evenings. Now, I don't want to ignore the elephant in the room, but on such a prestigious occasion, I feel it would be crass and borderline inappropriate to discuss my fee for tonight. So, let's just say I'm going to be putting in half the effort. To be honest, I haven't even cleaned my teeth. A woman may well be hosting this evening, but don't worry, I've still got two big fellas up there to keep an eye on me, you know, just to make sure my driving's all right. Wonderful to be here at the Royal Festival Hall. What a fabulous building. And just like my very good friend Mel, it too is celebrating 70 glorious years in the arts. Congratulations, Melanie. All my love to you. I know, such wonderful underpinning. Now, what do you think of the set? I mean, personally, I love it. For me, it really sums up the TV industry. It's glitzy, it's glamorous, and most importantly, it's two-faced. Turns out tonight, of course, I'm having to work alongside a massive organ. Now I know how Susanna Reid feels on Good Morning Britain. We are in for a cracking night tonight. We're going to be celebrating some of the finest talent from a year of incredible British television. And the cast of Love Island are here. If you haven't seen that show, it's about decent, hard-working people being callously sent home from an island they love. Thank God that could never happen in real life. Which gets me thinking. If arriving on a boat from another country is now a crime, then the next series of Cruising with Jane McDonald is going to be in a whole hell load of trouble. Before we kick off, a big shout to the general public up there. Hello, guys. And in true royal wedding style, do help yourselves to anything from your own picnic. What a year we've had, eh? Another royal baby born. I'm not saying there was pressure on Kate to look perfect afterwards, but apparently she couldn't hear if it was a boy or a girl over the sound of the hairdryer. The fantastic Jodie Whittaker became the first ever female Doctor Who. And, you know, much controversy followed, of course, because apparently some fans of space travel in a phone box, sonic screwdrivers and intergalactic alien races found it difficult to imagine that. For me, I think Jodie was the perfect choice. Because if there's one thing this year has taught us, if anyone's got experience fighting off grotesque monsters, it's an actress. How great to see the fabulous Blue Planet 2 nominated. Great, a magnificent piece of work. It was, if you haven't seen it, it's a bit like Blue Planet 1, only this time the penguins demanded bigger trailers. This was important television. It brought to our attention the damage single-use plastic is doing to our environment. Plastic finds its way into rivers, oceans, and some even found its way into the cast of Towie. The quality of British drama this year, I think you'll agree, has been utterly outstanding. The Crown, Peaky Blinders, Line of Duty, indeed. I suspect some of you have had a couple of lines of duty tonight. Incredible show, Line of Duty. Tandy Newton's perfectly realised character, DCI Huntley, proved you don't always need the long arm of the law. Sometimes the stumpy arm of the law works equally well too. Right. The time, I believe, has come. Who wants to take a big gold head home on a night bus? We are all... Come on, run the gauntlet, you crazy fools. We're on tenterhooks because every year the winners of the BAFTA TV Awards are an intensely, closely guarded secret. I mean, Facebook knows, obviously, but apart from that, we're all in the dark. But enough of my yakking, because I can quite frankly see the team from Grand Designs who are worried I won't be finished before winter sets in. Here is what all of you lovely lot have been up to this year.
Gonna love this.
My love,
my lover, 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 I'm in
paradise. Take a brave man to go poking around in here.
My mind. I'm not stupid, do you know what I mean?
Fancy yourself as a bit of a comedian, do you?
All right.
Come, Mr. Bond. Please, eat.
I wouldn't mind a tea, actually.
This is the worst thing we've ever done.
Reach too far!
He wants to go. Good luck to him, I say.
How did you go to the toilet?
In weightlessness, everything's just gonna hang around.
I am sorry.
Oh, congratulations.
Job done, then. Give another P45.
I'm Donald John Trump. I'm the least racist person that anybody's going to meet.
I think we should get the Queen involved.
Are you not?
Queen of the Jungle!
I am going to have you.
It's like we're in two different worlds. Hey, watch. Britain's Got Talent, for God's sake.
Guilty.
Perfect timing. Oh, yeah?
Obviously, somebody's a big name, but we're also a big name.
Who are these people?
No sensation at all.
I really have to up my game.
Backed ourselves a couple of hot wives by the sounds of it.
No thanks, love, but really?
Gotcha!
And gotcha!
Oh, you thought he'll to get me, mate?
Raxo! Good luck getting these guys together.
This is a bit flash, isn't it?
yet.
I still wish I'd done Strictly.
Joe and Katya!
Give me a break.
Oh, I love this! Love it!
Fabulous! Now lending his dulcet tones to the proceedings tonight, or even proceedings, is a man widely considered the David Attenborough of reality TV. It's the ever upbeat, despite all the things he's seen, Ian Stirling!
Hello, sir!
Hello, hot stuff. Now, just hearing your voice makes me want to pop that bikini on and get savagely rejected by a buff 21-year-old. Right, where was I? Let's have a look at the nominees for the first category. The nominations for drama series. Line of Duty.
How old are you, Kate?
31.
I'll tell you about my road to 31. I've been a DI 2 years already. And then I made life choices in the best interests of others. Not in my best interests at all, as it turned out. And from what I know, you won't make that mistake. You'd give up anything to get to the top.
The end of the effing world.
I reckon this'll do.
Yeah.
We can just chill here, plan our route, take our time.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think what adults do in situations like this. Should we go downstairs and have a glass of wine?
Yeah.
Peaky Blinders.
Anyone who wants to live to see another Christmas needs to come with it safe. These bastards will kill kids as well. When this business is finished, we can go our separate ways. Go and see Polly and explain. She'll have had a card as well.
Do you think I'm on the list?
We're all on the list, Ada.
The Crown.
Naked.
To present the award, please welcome our brilliant new Doctor Who and her gorgeous bit of fluff. It's Jodie Whittaker and Bradley Walsh!
Thank you very much, everyone. The Doctor will see you now.
What a geek. That's enough about us. We've seen some incredible drama over the past 12 months, but there's only one winner. So if my mate could do the honours.
Thank you. Here we go. And the BAFTA goes to...
Peaky Blinders!
Razor-bladed hats off to the cast and crew of Peaky Blinders. This is the first time they've taken home a prestigious TV BAFTA. Fans of the notorious Birmingham gang will be delighted to hear that a fifth series will be coming in 2019, with the sixth and seventh already confirmed. Prove that you can't keep Cillian Murphy and the Shelby family down. Ron Bear Dance Company will turn the show into a ballet. Peaky Blinders a ballet.
Where do I sign up? Thank you very much.
Wow. Thank you all so much. This is deeply, deeply appreciated, and you have no idea how much we owe to the guy I'm about to introduce, who's written every episode, 20 of them and counting, Steve Knight.
Well, thank you. This is great, and it means a lot to all of us, to all of the team. The geniuses who take a tiny budget and make a huge program. And everyone at Tiger Aspect, everyone who has been part of the whole thing. My parents who lived the real life of the Blinders. And the only cloud over it is I just wish that the people who have created some iconic TV characters, Cillian Murphy, Helen McCrory, Paul Anderson, that soon maybe they will be here as well, because I think they deserve to be. Okay, thank you.
We'd like to thank Snoop Dogg for his taste in British drama and his tweets.
I would like to thank the BBC. They're the best. Honestly, on behalf of all of us and everywhere, this is the biggest thing that's ever happened to me, for sure, and I want to thank all of you, every single one. Thank you so much.
Nominees Comedy Entertainment Programme. The Last Leg.
Yes, the crazy dictator with the weird barnet and dodgy family went head-to-head with North Korean leader Kim Jong-un this week. And do you know what? We've been putting money in the Trump jar whenever we talk about Donald Trump, but after this week, we're going to have to put a lot in to cover...
Is
you know
that
what?
Real money?
That is real
just
money.
He's done a deal outside or something. What's going on? Adam's just sold his leg.
Would I lie to you?
So, yes, I was holding an ice cream.
A cornet.
Pardon?
A cone or cornet,
yes.
As they're called.
Yeah, I was holding my ice cream.
What flavour of ice cream? What flavour of ice cream?
Your standard vanilla.
OK.
Standard vanilla?
Standard vanilla, yeah.
Okay.
That was a lovely Adam Ant song, wasn't it?
Taskmaster.
It was like an episode of The A-Team for about 2 minutes. I'm going to use these implements and then we just flip into someone having a mental breakdown.
Murder in Successville.
There's one final bit of the story that has seemed to cause somewhat upset. We are also not the Crenshaw McQuaffins. My name is Des Sleep. This is...
What's my name?
Martin Kemp.
Oh. I'm so confused with the names.
To present the BAFTA TV's biggest catastrophe until I mess up one of these lag links, it's the brilliant Sharon Horgan and Rob Delaney!
Hi!
Hello. Coming from the comedy world, we actually know all of the guys nominated tonight.
Yeah. We do, so in a way, it'd kind of be better for us if nobody won.
Somebody has to.
The BAFTA for Best Comedy Entertainment Program goes to...
Murder and Successful!
The fantastic Murder and Successful, celebrating tonight with our first ever nomination and BAFTA win. The show is now in its third series and could soon be running for a film award, with a feature-length movie adaptation having just been confirmed. Tom Davis, leading the charge, will collect the award, but don't worry, it's not a tiny BAFTA, it's just that Tom Davis is absolutely massive.
Yeah? Sweet. Nice one. What a touch. I won't bend or break it. It's been 3 years making this show. It's a show that we all love, and it's a show that the crew that we have the last 3 years have been incredible. Obviously, they're not here tonight, but they're an amazing group of people that just make this show something incredible and different, and it's a joy to make. I want to thank the cast, all of the guys who come and play around with us and dick about. Martin, Reggie, I can't remember all the rest. I wasn't expecting this. I had a broken face of ready. But the biggest thanks is to the BBC, who a couple of years ago took a risk on a show that was just mental and have run with it. So thank you very much. This is Jenny from A Boy from Croydon. This is Pretty Mad. Thank you.
And as the winners open the tap on another box of wine, let's say hello to some other guests here tonight. Great to see Love Island here, everyone.
There they are.
Not the island itself, of course. That's still getting hosed down. Seriously, guys, thank you for taking time out of your busy gym routines to be with us. And the cast of The Real Full Monty also here. Don't get up. Seriously, don't get up, guys. Believe me, I never thought there was a god until I saw Ashley Banjo naked. Believe me, I've brushed past softer dry stone walls.
That was good. Good, all right, yeah?
I'm so sorry, and yet I'm not sorry. I'm sorry, and yet I'm not sorry. On to our next award now, and this one features an absolute plethora of talent. Little Boy Blue, Blue with a top knot, AC-12's top boy, and boy, that was a great Black Mirror. Let's take a look.
The nominees for Supporting Actor. Adrian Dunbar, Line of Duty.
Justice would not have been further from your thoughts. Well, here is justice. Roseanne Huntley. I shall now be seeking the authority of the Crown Prosecutor to charge you with these offences, the murder of Timothy Ifield, and perverting the course of justice, do you understand?
Brian F. O'Byrne, Little Boy Blue.
What?
With a pellet gun?
No, it was a gun. It was a proper gun. He's been shot in the neck. He's in there now.
How bad is he?
Bad. What are they saying in there, Auntie Mel?
I don't know. Something about 25.
Shot?
Anupam Kerr, the boy with the top knot.
I used to ride a bike.
Did he?
I used to go everywhere on it. I went everywhere on the bike.
Achal, Makwasnagar, everywhere.
Mom.
He can't ride a bike.
I can.
Jimmy Simpson, USS Callister, Black Mirror.
Please don't do that. Don't. Oh, my God. Oh.
There's no genitals in Space Fleet. This is a wholesome universe.
He must have modified our code that way.
We're all the same. You don't believe me? Take a look down there.
We have tried grinding our mounds together out of sheer boredom.
To present the award, someone you'd think would be bored of red carpet by now. Please welcome from the Crown, our princess, Vanessa Kirby.
To shine in this particular category, the nominees have to have three main attributes. They have to be male, they have to be supporting actors, and above all, they have to be unbelievably talented. And as we've just seen, those guys tick all those boxes. So, the winner is Brian F. O'Byrne for Little Boy Blue.
Congratulations to Brian O'Byrne on his first BAFTA. His powerful performance in Little Boy Blue was truly exceptional, based on real events from an infamous day in Liverpool back in 2007 when young Everton fan Rhys Jones was tragically murdered. His portrayal of Rhys's father Stephen thoroughly deserves his BAFTA.
Thank you very much. I can't believe I'm going to be one of those people who didn't prepare anything. But I am, but maybe it's best because... thank you, BAFTA. Thank you for nominating me with the other wonderful actors. And everyone I worked with knows that I love them. I won't name them tonight because it's kind of difficult to get an award to play somebody who is living and who is at home tonight, like the last night for the last 10 years, suffering grief, the loss of their child. Thank you, Mel and Steve and Owen. I'd like to dedicate this to your young child, Rhys, who is tragically lost. Thank you to the City of Liverpool for embracing the story. Quadjo, Jeff for writing, my very good friend Paul, and Sinead and Stephen Graham, and the entire crew who knew that they were dealing with something that was such a tragedy. Thank you. I'm in shock.
Nations for miniseries. The State.
Now, all pharmacists have to take a re-education course. If you don't, they close you down. They teach you about the length of your beard and trousers and how far apart your feet must be in prayer. All very important when running a pharmacy.
Come on, for all Muslims, it's Abililla.
Of course.
The Moorside.
Come, love, it just do it.
I'm so back, Karen.
Oh, Julie, thanks for coming down.
Yeah, love. Come on. Sit down. All right. When did you last see her?
Yesterday afternoon. She'd been swimming with school. When they got back, she got off bus with others and no one's seen her since.
Three girls.
You're going with him. You're going with him. Holly, you're going with him. Amber, you're going with him too. I'll be back after you. All right?
I'll office.
Not going with anyone.
Here you are.
Howard's End.
Madam, you'll be more comfortable at the hotel.
Why, it's Henry.
Oh, bless us, what a person.
Oh, Hen, I'm sorry. I didn't know. I should have stayed at home. I'm so sorry, Hen. Truly, I am. I didn't...
I can't congratulate you enough on your protégé.
Henry, I'm awfully sorry.
Pray don't apologise.
Don't be angry, Hen. I'll go.
Why did she call you Henry? Has she ever seen you before?
Seen him before? Seen Henry?
She won supporting actress at last year's BAFTAs. Please welcome back the wonderful Wunmi Misaku and with her, Call the Midwife star, Helen George.
Four incredibly powerful dramas, even more thought-provoking when you consider that two of them are based on real-life events.
This year highlights, perhaps more than ever, just how dynamic and important the mini-series has become as a powerful storytelling tool in modern filmmaking.
The BAFTA goes to Three Girls.
This hard-hitting drama is based on the true accounts of the victims of the sex abuse scandal in Rochdale.
Thank you so much. Thank you to everybody at Studio Lambert and everybody at the BBC who supported us to make this incredibly difficult programme. I'd just like to acknowledge everybody else who was on this list, because those other dramas were also absolutely superb. The cast and the crew were the most committed and the most dedicated of any cast and crew that we've ever worked with, and a lot of them are here tonight. And that's because they were inspired by the courage of the real people who shared their stories with us and fought so desperately hard for justice. And Nicole wants to say something else.
To Sarah Robotham, Maggie Oliver, and the real three girls and their families. If people came to this programme, it's because of you. You stood up in court, you went to the police, you smacked down doors in pursuit of what now seems a basic truth, that there's no such thing as a child prostitute, only a child who's being abused. To the thousands of girls in the scores of towns who've been made to feel like you're not deserving of protection, and to all the Maggies and all the Sarahs who lost your careers and nearly lost your minds trying to get them heard, thank you. This is for you.
Factual. Celebrity hunted.
Seven celebrities. In one of the most watched...
We've got the CCTV in.
...and fame-obsessed countries in the world.
Not as safe as we think.
Can the famous really disappear?
Love Island.
Chris and Johnny, to be fair, they are nothing special look-wise.
Oh, my God.
Chris said it was Ken, but I knew that was Dom because Dom has got an ego as big as a house, you know what I mean?
Old people's home for four-year-olds.
Hello, Solomon. And Solomon came running straight at me and jumped on me. I didn't mind at all. I liked it.
Hello, you're coming to Hamish.
For our older volunteers, this might be the most physical contact that they've had with any other person for quite some time.
The real Full Monty.
Welcome by far to the biggest stars this country has to offer. It is, of course, Kerry and her cousin Curtin, a.k.a. Daisy May Cooper, and her brother Charlie.
Well, at least one of us takes the BAFTA seriously.
Well, at least I don't look like a poor man's Mackenzie Crook.
Let's just read the winner, shall we?
Yeah.
OK, and the BAFTA goes to Love Island.
An amazing win for Love Island, a show I think is inexcusably below par. Luckily for them, they have the greatest voiceover artist of all time who managed to make it the most talked about show of the last 12 months. Producers, you're welcome. Right, I'm going to put some pants on and join you on stage.
I knew this dress was a bad idea. Wow, a BAFTA. Wow. On behalf of all of us, thank you so much. It's been so brilliant watching the show grow over the last 3 years. A massive shout out to ITV2 and ITV, who are a brilliant channel to work for. A huge thank you to all the islanders for giving us so much of themselves. A massive thank you to all of the team. In fact, the rest of the production team are currently right now on a boat somewhere on the Thames, probably going crazy that we've just won this. So this is for everybody. Thank you so much.
The nominees for Supporting Actress. Anna Friel, Broken.
Why do people go to Mass, Father?
Oh, lots of reasons.
They get something out of it, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I got this and this, and I got the sack. So if I go tomorrow, what am I going to get? Cystitis.
Julie Hesmondhalsh, Broadchurch.
Do I get police protection?
No, sorry. Is there anyone I can call to come and be with you?
No.
A friend or a relative?
Did you not hear me?
OK.
Don't want anyone knowing.
Trish, you need support. You can't be on your own.
I am.
Liv Hill, Three Girls.
Ruby is pregnant. We'll need more tests to check for STIs. Are you gonna bash me face in? No, Ruby. No, why would you say that? Because that's what you always said. Me or Amber got pregnant before we were 16.
Come here.
Vanessa Kirby, The Crown.
A picture of disappointment and disgust. This is the look that every woman you ever know will come to share. This is what the next 40 years of your life will look like.
To present the BAFTA, a man who can only be described as the master. Well, actually, he can also be described as the wonderful actor, John Sim.
Well, I think you'll agree that what we saw there were four very seriously powerful performances. Unfortunately, there can be only one winner. So, the BAFTA goes to Vanessa Kirby for the crown.
Congratulations to the incredible Vanessa Kirby. This is the second time she's been nominated for supporting actress for her portrayal of Princess Margaret in The Crown, and she's finally been crowned with a BAFTA.
Oh my God. Wow, BAFTA, thank you so much. And the people in my category are just phenomenal, so this is just such an honour. I just felt like the luckiest person in the world to play somebody that was so colourful and vivid and brave and strong. And so actually this is for Margaret, wherever she is. So I have to thank Peter Morgan and Left Bank, Suzanne and Andy and Netflix, Ted, Ali, Nina, everybody for just being so supportive and wonderful to me, and Nina Gold and Robert Stern for casting me, to Christian Hedell and Newt Windsor, and to my family, Claire, my sister, the best sister ever, apart from my real one. Yeah, don't say that. No, but I actually do want to dedicate this to my sisters, Boo and Anna, because I couldn't have done a second without them. I played Scotland the Brave on bagpipes non-stop at home while I was trying desperately to get into character, so they were there utterly through it. So thank you very much. I'm so honoured. Thank you.
Now, while the winners backstage tuck into a multi-dietary requirements finger buffet, we're here in a room full of incredible presenters and journalists. And here's a chance to meet one of the new generation of roving reporters. He's only one pair of glasses and a Southeast Asian travel documentary away from taking my job. Please welcome the truly fabulous Braden Bent.
And I'm BAFTA Kids Young Presenter winner, and I'm here at the exclusive BAFTA nominees party to grill some of our favourite TV stars. Time to mingle. Can you give me about 5 tips on how to be a presenter?
Okay, I don't need to give you any tips because the 5 things I was going to say, they've already happened. You're obviously super smart, you're interested in people, you've got a microphone, you're dapper and smart. And the most important thing, you have a quiff.
What TV programme would you say is worth staying up for?
A programme called Car Share. Don't know if you've heard of it.
I've heard of it. I've not watched it yet. My mum and dad won't let me watch it. I wonder why.
A Line of Duty, I would say, but then I'd be pretty biased, you know. I take your point.
The TV show I love staying up for, and I don't think you'll be able to stay up for it for a while, is called Game of Thrones. Do you know Game of Thrones?
Yes, yeah. I do. Well, I've heard of it. I'm not allowed to watch it, apparently.
No, it's because your parents are responsible.
Blue Planet 2. Isn't it amazing?
Oh, it's great. Yeah. All the animals, some of them are huge.
Some of them are huge.
Oh, look, there's a catfish. And I'm like, catfish?
Catfish.
What's that? What would you tell your 9-year-old self?
My 9-year-old self, don't do that there.
Okay.
Do you want to be the new presenter?
Hopefully. Hopefully when I grow up, when you've retired, because I don't want to take your job.
It's a BBC though, there's not a lot of money in it, just telling you now.
I don't care about the money.
You will.
And breaking news, since that VT, Braden has actually been made head of acquisitions at Channel 4. Time now for specialist factual. It's not an easy genre to define, but it usually involves someone who has quite a lot of stuff in their house or someone who can't get out of bed without a winch. Here are the nominees.
The nominations for specialist factual in honour of Hugh Weldon. Blue Planet 2.
They beat their tails with such force that the shock waves stun the herring. And then the senseless victims are easily collected.
Elizabeth I's Secret Agents.
Cecil himself was born a commoner. He studied at Cambridge University, learned 5 languages and worked his way up. What he has, he earned. Now he has to take on a Lord of the Realm. But which one?
Basquiat, Rage to Riches.
He would paint the background and he might paint one line and then he'd go over to another and paint something and then come back to this one and scratch it out or put words on it. So it was a constant movement. It was like a dance.
Blitz, the bombs that changed Britain.
It plummeted to Earth at around 1,000 feet per second, heading towards a street in Canning Town. 30 seconds later, it found its mark. At number 8, Martindale Road.
Now please welcome the outlandishly talented stars of Outlander. It's Katrina Balfe and Sam Heughan.
It's wonderful to be presenting the Specialist Factual Award. That sounds so grand.
Yes, yes, and the word specialist makes it sound so much better than the any old factual award. So let's announce the Specialist Factual Award winner.
And the BAFTA goes to... Basquiat, Rage to Riches.
Nearly 30 years after his death, this documentary film of Jean-Michel Basquiat details how the self-taught Brooklyn-born artist rose to one of the true greats of the international art scene. In a recent auction, his skull painting sold for over $100 million. His incredible art is the beating heart of this BAFTA-winning film.
I think we're both a bit incredulous. Thank you very much. This is extraordinary. It's extraordinary to have had the incredible opportunity to make a film about an artist who broke barriers on a world historic level. And that is a very unique opportunity. And it's been said how the team is everything in filmmaking, and this is an extraordinary example of that. Janet Leigh, who's being particularly shy right now, is the I don't understand this at all, Janet. Is the executive producer who is a phenomenal, extraordinary executive producer who always has the back of the filmmaker and always wants the absolute strongest film possible. There's the dynamic duo at the BBC of Mark Bell and Adam Barker, who are an extraordinary team who from the very outset, from the very commissioning of this thing, wanted the very best film and would give their very best feedback at the absolute last minute of post-production. And that was always appreciated. The quality and the timing of their feedback was always brilliant. So thank you, BAFTA. And Janet, thank you.
No, thank you, David, and thank you, BAFTA. I'm amazed. Thank you.
The nominations for scripted comedy. Time Wasters.
Homeless Pete gave me some rules. Don't kill anyone.
That's not even specific to time travel.
Don't impregnate, get impregnated, don't touch any animals. Have fun and try to blend in.
Try to blend in? Am I the only one noticing that?
Catastrophe.
Sorry. What now?
I don't know. I guess over time I'll have to learn to forgive you.
Right. Over how much time?
I don't know. I guess it'll take 2 or 3 months. A season. What are you doing?
I'm just trying to work out if we'll be okay by my birthday.
No.
This country.
Yeah, so we can have that on the door. So you use that as a door knocker. Come through in here. Oh, it's all right. Pork chappies with me. Just, okay. And, oh, close your eyes. Show my best find, Levi. Okay. 1, 2, 3, and open.
What are you going to do with them?
Smash them on the road, probably, I would have thought.
Chewing gum.
Yeah, I'm going on a date. Yeah, literally the second my shift is done.
What?
Wow. Yeah.
What's his name?
Anthony Joshua.
The famous boxer?
Yeah, it's... It's obviously not Anthony Joshua, it's Anthony Joshua's friend. Basically, it's Anthony Joshua's friend that I'm seeing, you know. So, and he's picking me up in his car.
Fancy. So what's he whipping?
Excuse me?
What's he drive, your guy?
A Rolex.
To present, please welcome two of the funniest comedians on the planet, Catherine Ryan and Roisin Conaty.
We're presenting this award. We love and admire all the nominees, an absolutely brilliant bunch of shows.
I agree, they're all brilliant, and it's a shame there can only be one winner. But you know, it is important to remember that it's not all about awards.
Except it's literally all about awards. We're at the BAFTAs.
Yeah, but like, say you made a TV show and people watched it and they enjoyed it and like they did some tweets about it. That's sort of like an award as well, if you think about it.
Yeah, no, it's nothing like an award.
The BAFTA goes to... this country!
Massive congratulations to this country. The show, not our country, we've had an absolute shocker over the past couple of years. Written by talented siblings Daisy May and Charlie Copper, who were one of five BAFTA Breakthrough Brits nominated tonight. Fans will be delighted to hear a third series is already underway. On yourselves.
By saying a massive thank you to Shane Allen, who this show would never have even been made if he didn't have the faith in us. Chris Sussman, Steve McCrum, Damien Kavanagh.
We've got to thank our crew.
Yeah.
It takes so much hard work, you wouldn't believe it, to make it look like a documentary crew's just turned up and turned on a camera. So like, we share this with them for sure.
And the cast as well. Paul Chahidi, Ashley McGuire, happy birthday, by the way. And Trevor Cooper, our uncle, Uncle Trev. Our dad, Paul. Michael Sleggs. And Sluggs. Yeah, and everyone else in it as well. Thank you.
Thank you.
Now, I know you're all getting excited about next weekend. Devoted fans are going to be lining the streets to witness one of the nation's biggest and most watched events of the entire year. Because we love the passion, the pomp, the sheer romance of an FA Cup final. And we're going to stay with sport now for our special award. Because thank God we've got all the standard awards out of the way. The award is going to a footballing legend. And to present it, a man who used to warm up Jonathan Ross. Such different times. Please welcome... John Bishop.
Thank you. It's an honour for any football supporter to come and present this award, because this year the BAFTA Special Award goes to a legend of British broadcasting. For over 50 years, John Motson has truly been the voice of football. Finally, hanging up his microphone after commentating on this afternoon's match where Crystal Palace beat West Brom. A classic. For many like myself, John's voice is associated not only with memories of great football matches, but also with family times watching football together. His voice has united people in the passion and the emotion of the game, and over the course of this incredible career, Motty has commentated on over 2,000 matches, including 10 World Cups, 10 European Championships, 29 FA Cup Finals, and over 200 England games. He's also become a fashion icon, doing for the sheepskin jacket what Donald Trump has done for hairspray. Let's have a look at some of his work.
Special award.
Well, I'm afraid that Mark West and Martin O'Neill are going to have to wait a few days longer if they're going to add another chapter to Wickham's famous cup history. Radford again. Oh, what a goal! What a goal! Radford the scorer. Ronnie Radford. And the crowd. The crowd are invading the pitch.
We're appealing for offside. The Germans and they're in trouble. Alcantara couldn't do it. Lineker probably could. And England have equalised. It's Gary Lineker.
Congratulations, John Motson, on your special BAFTA award. It couldn't be more deserved. Growing up, you were the voice that I associated with football, whether it be Match of the Day, whether it was watching England games, big World Cup matches. What a career you've had.
Gascoigne has had his second yellow card of the competition, and here is a moment that almost brings tears to his eyes.
John Motson, the voice of football, I just wanted to say many congratulations on your award, a fantastic achievement.
And this is extraordinary. We're going to see the penalty spot painted, are we, during the match? Meantime, Colin Bolton is, I think, building a sandcastle. Oh, it's all... Gerrard! He's got it! Oh, Steven Gerrard! Just when he looked injured and out of it, and equalised for Liverpool!
John, congratulations on your award. Not only are you a fantastic commentator, but I've been very, very lucky to meet you in person, and you're a special man as well.
The crazy gang have beaten the Culture Club. I've never had anything like this in my career. The scenes in the commentary boxes for the last 45 minutes have been absolute mayhem and chaos.
For anybody watching in black and white, Spurs are playing in all yellow today.
I've been privileged to listen to you for so many years. Well done, John.
Enjoy your night, and I hope you and your family have a fantastic time.
Congratulations and well played.
Thank you to the producers for selecting all the Liverpool FA Cup wins. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for the irreplaceable John Motson.
I thought the ovation I got at Crystal Palace was good, but you've cracked it. Thank you very much. I just want to say one thing about this award tonight, because obviously it's an anniversary for me, as John kindly said, 50 years at the BBC. But I don't know how many of you have appreciated, it's also a celebration for British television. Because the year I first walked through the doors of Broadcasting House, 1968, was the year that colour TV came to this country. Give yourselves a round of applause. And just in case you don't think I've had my facts right, the first FA Cup final in colour was the following year, 1969. Anyway, there we are, or maybe even 68, I can't remember. Anyway, so therefore, I was excused for saying those watching in black and white are Spurs in the yellow shirts, because, you know, colour TV had only been in 2 years, but it didn't get any better. As I carried on, the gaffes kept coming. It's Arsenal 0, Liverpool 2. The longer it stays like that, the more you've got to fancy Liverpool to win. Then they sent me to the World Cup and I called it a truly international event. And then I commentated on the most iconic team in the world and I said, these Brazilians are so good, they're running around the pitch playing with themselves. Well, I've watched them teams playing from my elevated position for all those years. I must just say, like everybody else has tonight, and it is pretty lonely up here for me, but I'd have liked to have brought the whole Match of the Day team, really, because, as everybody knows, the commentator is only the voice at the end of a very professional and sometimes complicated process. So I'm dedicating this to the BBC Sports Department, where I've worked for, as you said, 50 years, and been so grateful to have so much professional support behind me. And to BAFTA, thank you ever so much. I never saw this coming.
And now we come to the time of the evening where we remind ourselves of some of the extraordinary people that we've lost this year.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, this is what I call a theatre. This is a place where you can sleep in comfort. And you will, I promise you.
I'm not going to stand here and bandy words.
No, you go. Go on, as a few motorists, see if you can get knocked down.
Oh, not gods, James. Just fumbling mechanics most of the time, working with pathetically inadequate tools on vehicles we've hardly begun to understand.
Good evening and welcome to Film 83. It's a curious convention, isn't it, whereby people like me sit in studios like this and grandly bid you welcome to your own homes. Bit of a cheat, really, I suppose.
Well, welcome to our Swapperama, and a very warm welcome, of course, to all our swappers. Hello!
Is it to the ground?
About 18 inches.
Oh, God, I'll never make it.
Take me to a tribunal, see what good that does you. I'll testify. Oh, my word, I will. I'll tell them what a dead loss you were as workers. Idle, shifty, and incompetent.
Let's meet three owners who've all got crabs. Hermit crabs, that is. They're going to run a crab-solutely fabulous race.
Man and woman get to in full, woman has baby in manger, angels sing on high, blah, blah, blah.
You have forgotten to mention that that baby is, in fact, the son of God.
Oh, yeah, I know. I mean, that's a nice twist.
This is my little friend, and today he's a little bit peeved. You see, I'm surrounded at the moment by 52 other little friends.
It's nice to see you, to see you.
Having a funny mood tonight. I hope it lasts.
And the music that accompanied that incredible tribute was composed by 19-year-old student Billy Elliston. And I'm sure in this room and watching at home, we'd all like to join in remembering Dame Tessa Jowell, the former culture secretary, a champion of the arts, and a truly compassionate and collaborative voice across the political divide. And now it's time to move to our next category. The nominations for features: The Secret Life of the Zoo.
Millions of us go to the zoo every year.
Breakfast! It's your favourite!
But what do the animals get up to when no one's looking?
Hey, you're so naughty!
Antiques Roadshow.
Well, I've brought my grandfather's watch. It was, for a while, the only thing he owned in the world. He was forced to flee Berlin. He put every single bit of currency he had into it because he saw it as his ticket out of Berlin and out of Germany.
Cruising with Jane McDonald.
Look at this. It's a bit flash, isn't it? This is amazing. A staircase made of Swarovski crystal. Look at these stairs. I bet the Kardashians have got three of these at home. Maybe four.
No more boys and girls. Can our kids go gender-free?
Men are better at, like, being in charge.
I think boys are cleverer than girls because they get into president easily, don't they?
To present the award, someone I consider to be the sexiest man on air, and yes, I did just say that out loud, from First Takes, it's Fred Cyriax.
As you've just seen, the nominated features this year not only highlight the wonderfully broad spectrum of subject matter, but also a huge variety of talent we are blessed with in this wonderful country of ours. So let's find out the deserving winner. Cruising with Jane McDonald. Huge congratulations to the whole crew on Cruising with Jane McDonald for winning its first BAFTA. Not to be confused with Cruising with Ian Stirling, which is a very different show. In this series for Channel 5, former cruise ship entertainer Jane McDonald took us on a fabulous journey across the sea, and fans will be delighted to hear a third series is on the horizon. Get off Jane's dress. All aboard!
Neck.
That is so not. I just know. I've even had this written for me because I thought there's no way we're winning that. Wow. It even says wow on here. Well, thanks to the British Academy and congratulations to the other nominees. It's very humbling to have won, but I feel we're all winners tonight. Every one of us in here is winners tonight, aren't we? My heart is going so fast. Can't believe it. Thank you also to all our wonderful viewers who watch it and have made this show such a hit. I thank you and I'm so grateful. Firstly, I'd like to thank Channel 5. Channel 5, you go! Channel 5. For commissioning this series, Ben Frau and Greg Barnett, it was your vision and your support that made this all a reality. And this award is a testament to your channel's evolution. And I'm proud to be a part of this. I really am. I started this amazing journey with a fantastic team, Fee Cotter Craig, John Cohen, James Peters and Baron Money. Thank you so, so much. But the adventure continues with a fabulous new team as well, Mark Powell, Tim Markwald, Ray Eastman, David Kirkham, Chris Agathangaloo. Thank you, Chris. What would we do without you? And Jeff Anderson. Special thanks also go to Darren Lilly, Ian Chisholm, Sue Ravey and the amazing John Dixon. Great music, John, thank you. This is a great achievement for Elephant House Studios, and thanks to Joe McCluskey, Maureen McPhee, and my agent, Craig Latto. Thanks for your patience. Finally, I'd just like to say a big thank you to the man without whom none of this would be possible, and that's my wonderful partner, Ed, who just sees the back of my head going, I'm off on my holidays again, see you when I get back. Mum, look what I'm bringing home. It's so lovely. Thank you, BAFTA. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. The nominees for male performance in a comedy programme. Toby Jones, Detectorists.
Hello, Dad. Sorry, I'm running late again.
OK, we need to have a chat.
Dad, can we maybe take this down, this poster?
Well, the tennis lady? Why?
Don't you think it's a bit tacky?
Tacky? No.
and a bit, well, degrading to women.
Kate, she's scratching her bottom.
Dad, she's got no knickers on.
Hasn't she?
Asim Chowdhury, People Just Do Nothing.
No one can control somebody. I do my own thing when I want to. I'm the boss of me, you know what I mean? I don't run by anyone's rules. I do what I want, mate. I'm a free spirit, you know?
Charlie?
Yes, what?
Yeah, your lunch break's over.
Yeah, no worries. I'll...
Samson KO, Famalam.
Why is nobody getting back to me with assistance for the gold transfer? There is a fortune to be made here. I can't believe I can't get anybody interested. Somebody must want it. In here, babe. Baby. Just dear. Well, all I can do is keep on emailing.
Mr. Norton Smith.
Rob Brydon, The Trip to Spain.
Oh, no, Steve. Oh, look.
Oh, no.
But what do we do? We...
Well, you just take one.
All right.
Wow.
Well, here it is, Mr. Coogan. We managed to get it out. I mean, the good news is it's benign. The bad news is we found 7 more of them.
Please welcome none other than Marvel's Agent Carter.
Oh, God. I hope I haven't just blown her cover.
It's Hayley Atwell.
Hello. Wow, Sal. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and my mum at home. This autocue script begins, as a country, we are blessed. And we are, but I don't feel entirely qualified to speak for the whole country. So I just want to say it's an honour to be here to celebrate the nominees this evening. Their hard work and talent have given us a good old laugh this year. And the BAFTA goes to Toby Jones.
Toby plays keen metal detector Lance in this amazing comedy series created by Mackenzie Crook for BBC Four. The Detectorist won a TV BAFTA for scripted comedy in 2015, but this is the first time Toby has won a BAFTA of his very own. Well done, Toby. Have a little speech now.
Thank you. Thank you very, very much. I'm deeply honoured. It's impossible to talk about Detectorist. It's impossible to talk about Detectorist. It's impossible to talk about Detectorist without talking about the great Mackenzie Crook. He approached me on a film set and said, listen, I've got this thing, you won't want to do it. Do you mind if I send it? Send it back, delete it when you see it. You won't want to do it, but I have to send it to you because you're who I thought of when I played the role. He rang me just before this. He said, what are you doing tonight? And I said, going to the BAFTAs. And he said, I said, what are you doing? He said, I'm training my Robin in the back garden. He is training his Robin in the back garden. Thank you to Mackenzie. Thank you to everyone involved with the show. All actors say it, but it's true. You're only as good as the cast that's around you and the scripts that get written. Fantastic producers at Channel X and Lisa. Thank you, BBC Four. And most of all, thank you to Karen, Madeline and Holly, who, without whom I can't do my job. Cheers.
Well, what an evening so far. I wish I was at home watching this, because quite frankly, I'd be 5 rum and tizers down with Mary Berry by now. I'm up here with the people who count, the viewers, the veterans, the people that loyally sit through the good, the bad, and the quite frankly cancelled after one series. But now it's time to reveal who's won your vote for Virgin TV must-see moment. My favourite TV moment in my house was when my cousin unwittingly streamed his iPhone's photos to our Apple TV. Certainly broke the ice at Easter. To present this award, a fantastic pair of presenters. And if you don't win, don't worry. They will simply hug the sorrow out of you until you're bone dry. Please welcome Emma Willis and Dermot O'Leary.
You are a good hugger and you are a good dress carrier.
Let her be the fruit.
Thank you very much, Dermot O'Leary. We are here this evening to present the Virgin TV Must-See Moment Award.
Or as we like to call it, the... Oh, my God, did you just see that? Quick Rewind It Award. Let's take a look at the nominations.
Nominees for Virgin TV's Must-See Moment.
A mother is holding her newborn young. It's dead. She is reluctant to let it go and has been carrying it around for many days.
Few days left, now it's a sad thing. Got three girls, it's cute.
Oh! Oh my days, what the sick.
Obviously, Stormzy's a big name, but we're also a big name, so it's just seeing like a friend.
He's a fan of us and we're a fan of him, and we share the love, and that's what we do as peoples.
What's going on?
That is one mixed bag.
Okay, are you ready, Dermot? Uh-huh. I haven't peaked. I normally peak, but you're I have peaking. Not you're peaked today. The winner is Blue Planet 2.
To capture this unbelievable moment and many others, the camera crew spent 6,000 hours filming underwater and used incredible cutting-edge technology, including bubble-less diving equipment. It's the future.
Thank you so much for this BAFTA and for all the audience for voting for us. This series would not have been possible without the passion and dedication of our extraordinary production team and the bravery of our underwater crews. We, over 4 years, launched over 125 filming expeditions, spent over 6,000 hours underwater, often in testing conditions. And thank you to our extended family and friends for putting up with all that. But lastly, I'd like to thank the inspiration to us all, Sir David Attenborough.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very, very much indeed. I speak, I think, for all of us. We set out to try and show the seas, the oceans, for what they are, their beauty, their wonder, their splendor, their intricacy, but also the truth about what we are doing to them. And the fact that that one particular moment, which you've just seen, rang a bell in the minds and the consciences of people throughout this country is something that pleases all of us more than I can say. Thank you very much indeed.
Unbelievable.
Now, I am here on a lovely old lady. What's your name, dear? What's your name?
Listen, you might be hosting this show, but you're not beyond a good tickling.
Get
Let's
off.
Give her a good little tickle. Come on.
I'll put one of my jugs in your face.
Come on.
Now,
Yes, come on, love. Have I won something?
No, love.
Oh,
that's
darling.
Never gonna happen.
Oh, darling.
Can you please finally tell me how you pronounce your surname?
It's Giedroyc.
Giedroyc. How do you spell that?
G-I-E-D-R-O-Y-C.
Is that Lithuanian?
It's Lithuanian. Okay. Yes, it's Lithuanian.
Do you have your documentation with you? I'm just asking.
No, I don't. I'm sorry.
Different
times. I should go.
There's a slight ripple come through the upholstery, and I'm wondering, is that you or me? Here are my boots. Anyway.
What's this? What are you wearing? It's all lovely.
Get off it. It's expensive. Get off. I'm trying to do my job. Get off it. If only there was a spectacular way to get out of this situation.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're Strictly champions.
I think I've been bejazzled by pixies. Ladies and gentlemen, the dancers and champions of Strictly, everyone!
And, wait for this, gang. The scores are in. Oh, there you go.
Excellent! Finally!
Nominees for soap and continuing drama. Hollyoaks.
We shouldn't do this, Hunter.
Why shouldn't we?
You know why?
Nobody's here to see us. So who cares what anyone else thinks? Just you.
and me. Nothing else matters.
Casualty.
You in stab?
Is Ethan okay? Is
Ethan?
As far as I know, yeah, don't worry about Ethan. Let's concentrate on you, shall we?
No, I want to die.
Yeah, I'm not going to let you die, Charles. I'm not going to let you die, okay?
Emmerdale.
Promise me, you will live your life. You'll do all the things I couldn't. Go everywhere. Do everything. Love till your heart bursts.
Coronation Street.
Oh, no, that's a cool entrance. Wow, that makes a change from the limo.
That was incredible, gotta say. Shall we present the award to one of those beautifully, brilliantly presented soaps and continuing dramas, shall we?
Indeed.
Yes.
And the BAFTA goes to... Casualty!
Massive congratulations to all the cast and crew of Casualty. This is Casualty's 14th nomination in this category and only their second win. Casualty was first broadcast on BBC One in 1987 and remains the longest running medical drama in the world, after My Mother's Cataracts.
Thank you, this is absolutely incredible. Thank you to BAFTA for this and for a wonderful evening. We'd like to thank everyone who watches the show. The doors of Holby City Hospital have been open for 32 years now, which is an amazing achievement, especially when you consider the dubious mortality rates of both the patients and staff there. Congratulations to all the other nominees in this category. Maintaining the high standards of a long-running drama like these wouldn't be possible without without a large team of dedicated, upbeat, talented people, and I'm very pleased to say that we're lucky enough to have those at Casualty. So this is for you, for everybody involved with the show who works so hard to make it what it is. Thank you. Thanks.
The nominees for Entertainment Performance. Graham Norton, The Graham Norton Show.
I've had excellent, excellent medical care by your English medical system. Thank you all very much.
Well.
And yeah. I have one of these big boots on.
No, it's a very... Can I just say, we don't all get such a nice, clean, space-age boot.
It's really...
Often it's just newspaper and string.
Yes.
Michael McIntyre, Michael McIntyre's Big Show.
Ladies and gentlemen, our unexpected star of tonight's show and those...
I don't know.
That was crazy. Did you enjoy it? Did you feel relaxed?
A lot, yeah.
Have you ever heard a noise like that?
No.
Embarrassingly, neither have I.
Sandy Toksvig, QI.
They have speeds of up to 2.79 times the speed of wind. So unbelievably quick. Say to me, what did Stephen say to you as he left? And the truth is, he shook his head and went, you have no idea.
Adam Hills, The Last Leg.
Is it okay that TV host Ruth Langsford this week described partner Eamon Holmes as being, and I quote, like a steam train in the bedroom?
Fair play.
Is Fair it okay to think that's because he hasn't been in regular service for 20 years and only gets a run on bank holidays?
Please welcome Successful's favourite and only detective, joined by our girl, Michelle Keegan.
Good evening, honoured to be here tonight.
Davison Keegan, you know, so this feels like a hell of a double act, you know?
Oh, yeah. Little and large.
Chalk and cheese.
Sweet and sour.
A little bit like Malcolm and Wyatt.
Beauty and the Beast.
All right, Michelle.
some s'mores.
Oh, that's enough, actually. And the winner of Best Entertainment Performance goes to...
Sorry.
Graham Norton for the Graham Norton Show. Sadly, Graham can't be here tonight, so I'll make sure he gets this award. It's probably sort of drinks that all of us BAFTA winners go to or something. So keep hold of this. All the best.
Well, while the winners are all enjoying themselves backstage, I'm here with a Commonwealth gold medal winning women's netball team. Enjoy the rest of the show. You guys, you... Properly the best. I'm loving this formation, by the way. Just tried to join in, not working. Slightly elbowed you in the hip then, for which I'm very sorry. You played a blinder in your match, which I'm sure lots of people saw. You scored right at the very last minute. And to top that off, girls, later on at the party, you can listen to some men explaining the rules to you. Great. Next up, we've got the BAFTA for single documentary. Top tip, don't ask them why they're single. They really hate it. And they prefer you call them strong, independent documentaries that don't need others to validate their existence. Basically, this is the only BAFTA category that's seriously considering getting a cat.
Nominees for single documentary in honour of Robert Flaherty. Rio Ferdinand, Being Mum and Dad.
I love my wife more than anything. Me and Rebecca, we had an unbelievable relationship. And her personality, she was always messing about and laughing at herself and stuff, which was a massive part of her personality.
I love doing this.
Yeah.
I'm going to start doing this every day.
One Deadly Weekend in America.
You don't see murder on this kind of scale with this kind of frequency in any other advanced nation on Earth. Every country has violent, hateful, or mentally unstable people. What's different is not every country is awash with easily accessible guns.
Chris Packham, Asperger's and Me.
Imagine all those people trapped in their room. Because they are isolated by this condition. They haven't been able to sculpt opportunities, manage themselves in a way that allows them to fulfill their lives. That's like a ghastly sentence set in a vile fairy tale. No one should be imprisoned by this condition.
Louis Theroux, talking to anorexia.
Maybe the fact that I want to tell you to eat...
You're frustrated.
I feel like maybe that's another way, maybe that in some level...
You're frustrated.
Is that how you want me to respond, maybe? Like that, so that I'm like a parent to you?
He's good, isn't he?
I don't know.
To present the BAFTA for single documentary, stars of Bulletproof, Noel Clark and Ashley Walters.
Documentary filmmaking has always been and remains the most vital way of telling stories that other mediums simply can't tackle.
The four nominees tonight truly deserve this recognition because finding and telling the truth is a skill that should be celebrated and cherished. And the BAFTA goes to...
Rio Ferdinand, Being Mum and Dad.
After losing his wife to cancer, Rio Ferdinand filmed a very personal documentary centred around the issues of bereavement. Rio bravely revealed the struggles he faced being the sole parent to three young children. This BAFTA-worthy documentary is bold, honest and moving.
Quite used to picking up trophies, but I don't normally have to speak after. So I'd just like to say thanks, firstly, to BAFTA and all the other nominees. Some great people up there, but also to BBC for believing in the project. All the guys at New Era, my management team, who are part of the production team too. It's been quite a crazy whirlwind experience, really. I didn't do this for any other reason than my three kids. Probably the worst thing to come out of this is that I get quite emotional now. It's allowed me to kind of speak and show vulnerability that people probably were never used to. Being a sportsman, you're built up as a indestructible kind of athlete. And for people to see that vulnerability live and direct, I think was a huge part of the making of the documentary. And I think that all of the nans, the granddads, the younger people, middle-aged people who come up to me now in the streets don't want to talk about football. So that means that we've done a good job with what we're doing. And people speaking out, allowing themselves to feel that vulnerability, that lacking in character, lacking in confidence, this has truly been worthwhile because it's allowed them people to speak and it's given them a voice. And seeing the documentary and looking back, as I said at the beginning, was part of something that was going to be there for my three kids. And that was like a snapshot of that time of sadness. And I'm just pleased to say that this documentary has been a part of playing a part in propelling me forward into a period of happiness in my life now, where my kids are very happy. I've got a beautiful girlfriend now, and we're making steps in the right direction. And with the thanks for the people behind me, and there's many more behind the scenes. Again, BBC, thank you very much. Thank you.
The nominees for Female Performance in a Comedy Programme. Anna Maxwell Martin, Motherland.
Do you have long lockers?
What?
Long lockers? Lockers that are long lockers, if you have something long that you need to hang up. Full-length lockers, like a wardrobe. Just, my jacket's getting very crumpled. It's a designer jacket.
Why are you wearing a designer jacket to a swimming pool?
Do you have long lockers?
No.
Daisy May Cooper, This Country.
If he wants to go, good luck to him, I say. I reckon he thinks I can't live without him, which is a laugh, because he went a whole weekend away once to Breen Sands, and I got on all right. I just ended up following this cat around the village. Levi, that needs to go way higher, mate.
Sharon Horgan, Catastrophe.
I don't think I'm a terrible person, but I guess I was angry.
Don't do that. Don't blame me.
I was upset about the money you gave Fergal and the French hussy and the fact that, you know, you wouldn't apologise or admit that you'd done anything wrong. And, you know, it's a tough time. There's a lot of Brexit, you know, your new president.
Don't put that on me.
Well, I'm just saying it's a tough time.
Sean Gibson, Peter Kay's Car Share.
I'm stuck.
Get your balls stuck. Come on. Come on. How do you look? Morning. We're going to be on bloody crime watch at this rate. Come on. On three.
I can't, John, I can't.
Three.
John, no.
Two.
No, no, no.
One.
Please welcome a comedy giant in every sense of the word, the irrepressible Greg Davies.
It is an absolute honour to present the award for Best Female Performance in a Comedy. Despite remarkable achievements, women in the comedy industry continue to struggle for the parity of opportunity and recognition that their talents deserve. So, who better to hand out such an important award than a fat, middle-aged man? Not even one of normal height, ladies and gentlemen. A giant man. A towering symbol of male privilege, who, in just two short minutes, will be standing next to the winner like a grotesque metaphor for all that is wrong with gender inequality. Great to be here at BAFTA. And the winner is the marvellously talented Daisy May Cooper.
Daisy May Cooper is taking home the BAFTA for Outstanding Performance as Kerry in This Country, a series co-created and written with her brother Charlie.
Sorry, I had to take my shoes off because I was in absolute agony. £10 from eBay, these were. I just want to say a massive thank you to Shane Allen, the incredible Mason sisters, Simon Mayhew-Archer, Tom George, my partner Will, who I got engaged 2 days ago as well. My wonderful mum and dad, Viv, Shaz, Nicolina, and Deb and Emma. And yeah, just thank you so, so much. And oh yeah, Charlie, thanks.
Well, what a fantastic evening it's been so far. If this was an episode of First Dates, I would definitely try and cop off with it in the back of a cab. We're down to our final four awards, and next it's the BAFTA for Entertainment programme, and we all love a shiny floor, unless, of course, it's in the opening scene of Casualty, and someone's in socks, and carrying a baby. Nominations for Entertainment programme in honour of Lou Grade, The Voice UK. Ant and Dec Saturday Night Takeaway.
Four, 3, 2, 1, squeeze my hand, there you go. Oh, I tell you what. Ant was very happy towards the end there. Come over this side. There you go. You said, I've always said, there's only one winner in Ant versus Dec, and that's entertainment.
That's right, dear.
Michael McIntyre's Big Show.
Thank you for spending a little bit of time away from your mobile phones, because I know it's a little tense in the modern world. I don't know what happens to chargers. Everybody gets a charger with their phone. Why do households always end up with one charger in the kitchen that everybody fights and steals? There's no love in homes anymore. People will steal power now.
Britain's Got Talent.
Oh, I don't know what was next. He was on it warming up.
Honestly thought you were going to do something like Ness and Dorma. Instead, you make those weird noises, so...
Don't give up the day job.
You said it.
Playing together tonight, please welcome to Sporting National Treasures. They're both balding. It's Claire Balding and Sir Mo Farah.
I'm just so delighted to be here tonight to present this award, standing alongside Britain's greatest ever distance runner, Sir Mo Farah. But Mo, we've got to be quick.
You know I'm a marathon runner now, Claire.
Yeah, so?
I don't do a run less than 2 hours every day.
Such a show-off. The BAFTA for Entertainment Programme goes to... Britain's Got Talent!
This is the fifth nomination for Britain's Got Talent and the second time it's won. The last time was 8 years ago in 2010 for those that are awful at maths. Broadcast since 2007, BGT is now in its 12th series, which is two more than 10 for those that are awful at maths.
Thank you very much to BAFTA, thank you very much to ITV, especially the phenomenal Shu Green and Lou Major. Thank you to all our production team, to all the crew who are amazing. We are really lucky to make this show. We love making this show. Thank you to everyone at Thames, especially the lovely Charlie Irwin and Dawn Gray, who never gets a reference. She's amazing. And also thank you to everyone at Psycho, Liam McNicholas, Nigel Hall, and the wonderful Richard Holloway. And obviously to all our talent. We have the best panel and the best hosts, and it's wonderful to make this show. So thank you very, very much. And also thank you to our contestants, because they make this show what it is. They are brilliant, and we can't do it without them. So thank you.
And now the highest honour that BAFTA can possibly give, the Fellowship Award. An award with more history and prestige than even Danny Dyer's lineage. To present it, please welcome the fantastic Kate Silverton.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am so honoured to have been asked to present the BAFTA Fellowship this evening. It is the highest accolade Sue Seb BAFTA can bestow, and the person receiving it is a genuine hero of mine. I became a journalist because of her. I was able to report from Iraq and Afghanistan because she had forged the path before me and so many other young women who followed her lead. We first met when I was a cub reporter in the Northeast, and she generously gave me her time and some of the best career advice I've ever had. We recently stood side by side to campaign outside Parliament for equal pay in this industry, our industry. She remains a fearless trailblazer. Most of us at some time have heard her reports from the world's most dangerous conflict zones, her cool, crisp voice serving to bring home the tragedy of conflict, be it in the Balkans, the Gulf Wars, Northern Ireland, or Rwanda. Her care, her tenacity, determination, and fearlessness knows no bounds, as we saw in her reports from Tiananmen Square, when she remained to report despite the great risk to her personal safety. She has worked for the BBC all her life, rising from local radio to its chief news correspondent. Her career, as many of you will recall, came to prominence in 1980 when her live coverage of the Iranian embassy siege interrupted the World Snooker Championship, reaching millions of homes across the country, and a broadcasting legend was born. Kate Adie is exceptional. As a broadcast journalist and author, she's always displayed a hunger for the truth and always found a way of telling it clearly, no matter how complex the story. I can pay her no bigger compliment, perhaps, than to say that Kate is revered by her peers, especially her female colleagues. She is kind, brave, brilliant, determined, and utterly deserving of this fellowship. Let's take a look at some of her pioneering work.
Fellowship.
The fire-damaged Iranian embassy in London, sealed off by the police, Kate Adie has been to the embassy this morning.
Inside the building are the bodies of three of the gunmen who died when the SAS stormed the embassy.
Our correspondent Kate Adie reports from the bloody streets of Peking.
After hours of shooting and facing a line of troops, the crowd is still here.
Hundreds of people fled in panic. A man was shot and fell dead 2 feet in front of me.
Sheer numbers are part of the military argument with Saddam Hussein.
The pace of the training increases all the time, and so does the scale of this huge operation.
One of the most likely hazards in Kosovo, the mines and the unexploded bombs and the ammunition that is lying around.
The consequence of having to operate in an area where there has been a great deal of fighting and random violence for months on end.
The people of Sierra Leone, who have little faith in the ability of the UN to bring peace to their country.
The Sierra Leoneans are apprehensive. The British have said they'll stand by them, but the war still goes on. Kate Adie, BBC News, Freetown.
Kate Adie, BBC News, Peking.
Kate Adie, BBC News, Pristina.
Kate Adie, BBC News, Kosovo.
Kate, thank you very much. We'll be talking to you later, we hope. But for the moment, thank you very much indeed.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my great pleasure to welcome to the stage this year's recipient of the BAFTA Fellowship Award, Kate Adie.
Thank you so much. I should first of all, with my history,
explain a broken arm not sustained in a foxhole in a war zone, but an accident in a pothole in a pavement. And I'm here tonight to say a huge thank you to BAFTA and to the BBC. I spent my working life with the BBC, starting in local radio. I never imagined I would be a reporter. I was a humble station assistant. But in my very first few months in the BBC, I encountered one of its great traditions to be taken very seriously, the weather forecast. Unfortunately, on local radio, we couldn't afford the Met Office forecast. So on local radio, I used to say, here is the weather, race to the window and have a good look out. And from there, I found myself heading into journalism, rather by mistake. I have to say thank you to three men. There were hardly any women around in senior jobs then. David Wayne, Robin Walsh, and Chris Kramer. And they said to me, get out there and do it. So I did. And I'm also going to say so much in the way of thank you to great colleagues in the BBC who made reporting possible, sometimes in very difficult circumstances. I've been very lucky. I think that being a reporter is just a wonderful job. It's fascinating, it's surprising, it demands a lot of you, but it is so rewarding. And you get the chance via television to tell people at home all about it. It's a fabulous feeling. And I also think that it's important because it's essential in a democracy. We hold truth to power. We tell it like it is. And in these times, I think that is even more important than ever. There are challenges, such as, I remember, several months in the first Gulf War, in a Middle East desert, the only woman with 43,000 British troops. No facilities, no trees, no bushes. Well, a woman just gets on with it. Of course we do. And you also remember when you're on your way to war to put in your earrings. It's a wonderful job to do. I've had marvelous colleagues, great support from the BBC. But over all of those years, I've learned one very special thing. It's an absolute privilege to be a reporter. Thank you.
The incredible Kate Adie. You just don't get disaster zone reporting like that anymore. Well, not unless Ollie Murs is trapped in Selfridges, that is. Now, as Miriam Margolyes likes to say, let loose a big one.
The nominees for leading actor. Jack Rowan, Born to Kill.
5673928. Your code, Kathy.
Tim Pigott-Smith, King Charles III.
But now I'll rise to how things have to be. The Queen is dead. Long live the King. That's me.
Sean Bean, Broken.
Now, I'm gonna pray that you realise the enormity of what you've done. I'm gonna pray that you realise the enormity of what you did and the lives you damaged.
Joe Cole, Hang the DJ, Black Mirror.
Everything happens for a reason.
All right, well, undo it then, make it go back.
I cannot do that. Recalibrating.
What if she looks at it?
Once shortened, the expiry date cannot be extended.
Why?
Everything happens for a reason.
to present the BAFTA for leading actor, a huge talent who probably deserves something much more important than the lad of Love Island introducing her. Please welcome the wonderful Jolie Richardson.
Good evening. Four simply stunning performances by four simply stunning actors. All of them have raised the bar. And the BAFTA goes to Sean Bean for Broken.
Sean's role as priest father Michael Kerrigan in Jimmy McGovern's Broken was truly outstanding and heartbreaking. Jimmy said he never even considered anyone else for the role.
Oh, thank you very much, everyone. Thanks, BAFTA. And this means a great deal to me. I'm really honoured, and it means such a lot to me. I don't think I'd be in this situation without the great mind and the great writing of Jimmy McGovern. It was an inspiration to me. I'd worked with him before, and he's an incredible man who shines a light on some of the darker aspects of our society. I'd like to thank Colin McEwan and Donna Malloy, the producers of the show, and my good friend Gary Armstrong, who you'll know why, and my wife Ashley. And I'd just like to say thank you. I'm really, really honoured and absolutely delighted. Thank you very much.
And now onto the award for leading actress. And there's one thing that all these wonderful women have in common. They're just delighted Olivia Colman isn't on the list. It would be too good. Here they are.
The nominees for leading actress. Tandy Newton, Line of Duty.
Who knows what people think of each other?
Is that your answer?
We didn't talk much. Didn't socialise.
So you've never been to his flat?
Yes. To investigate his murder.
Molly Windsor, Three Girls.
Why does everything have to be so miserable?
Molly, get back in the house now!
At me mates, there's no one standing at the window waiting to kick off.
Is that right? Well, if you like it so much, why don't you go live there then?
Fine.
Sinead Keenan, Little Boy Blue.
You need to go in there and check with them. Because they've just told me he's died and he can't laugh, so will you check, please?
Auntie Mel, they know what they're talking about.
No, go and check, please.
Claire Foy, The Crown.
I've had three prime ministers, all of them ambitious men, clever men, brilliant men. Not one has lasted the course.
Presenting the award for leading actress, please welcome one of Britain's finest acting exports, the one and only Martin Freeman.
Thank you very much. A pleasure to be here. There's not much to say after seeing those performances other than, my God, weren't most of those good? Jokes, they were all good. They were all great. And it's my absolute pleasure to be giving this award to somebody in this envelope. And the BAFTA goes to Molly Windsor for Three Girls.
An acceptable achievement for Molly, who had her first starring role in Samantha Morton's directorial debut, The Unloved, when she was 11. Now a leading actress, BAFTA, and all before she's 21. Incredible.
There's so many talented people who poured their heart and soul into the making of Three Girls. Philippa, Rhea, Liv, Shaheen Bey casting, Matt D.O.P., Nicole, Una, Maggie, Sara, so many people that worked so hard on Three Girls. But Three Girls was born out of the courage of the real Three Girls. and the real Holly, Amber and Ruby that told this story over and over and over, and then they told it to us again. And I just want to say thank you for everyone to recognising how selfless that is and how brave that is. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we've got one more trick up our sleeves. Please welcome Magical Bones.
What's up, BAFTA? I'm Bones, I do magic, and tonight I'm gonna make sure every single person here is going home with some BAFTA gold.
Thank you, Magical Bones. Thank you, sir. Best sleight of hand I've seen since Amber Rudd made all those landing cards disappear. That is all from us from the Virgin TV British Academy Television Awards 2018. What a pleasure it has been to be in front of you. I've been Sue Perkins. You've been simply wonderful. Good night, all.
Awards presented earlier. Sport.
And the BAFTA goes to
the Grand National.
I just want to say a huge thank you to the jockeys, the trainers, the owners, and the horses, most importantly, that make it possible.
News coverage.
The Rohingya crisis, Sky News.
Thank you very much. Honestly, I did not expect this. I've been saying all day it's going to go to Channel 4.
Current affairs.
Undercover Britain's immigration secrets, panorama.
We're honoured, indeed genuinely shocked. It's such a strong category, particularly this year.
International.
The Handmaid's Tale.
I just got a shout out to my mum. I love you, mum. Thank you very much.
Live event.
World War I remembered, Passchendaele.
I know everybody says it's all about the team, but actually when it comes to a huge live event, it is all about the team.
Short form programme.
Morgana Robinson Summer.
We made this short and a bunch of other shorts so we could showcase female directors who weren't really getting an opportunity to make longer form programmes. So we want to thank all those female directors for coming on this journey with us.
Factual series.
Ambulance. It was our privilege to be able to capture the way they work with such compassion and care. So it's our love song to the NHS this series. So thank you. Thank you.
And single drama.
Murdered for being different.
It's our duty and our privilege as filmmakers to not look away from the dark corners in our society.